This is the IVF technique which could prevent life-threatening diseases being passed on. The nucleus of an egg and a sperm are being removed from an embryo with faulty mitochondria and being put into a healthy donor. A team at Newcastle University did studies on more than 500 donor eggs and now think they have the technique ready.
So we've examined many, many embryos now, and we're confident on the basis of our results that these embryos are indistinguishable from embryos created by normal IVF and that they will give rise to healthy pregnancies.
Mitochondria are the power packs of our cells, but when faulty can cause a huge range of diseases in the muscles, heart and other organs. Within hours of IVF, the parents' key DNA that shapes our appearance and personality would be removed, leaving behind the faulty mitochondria. All the key genes would be placed into a donor embryo that's had its DNA removed and contains only healthy mitochondria. Any child born and future generations would have DNA from three people, although only 0.1% from the donor in the mitochondria.
It's affected her quite badly, really. It's affected her mobility. Mm-hmm.
Claire Exton's mum, Norma, died after her lungs and heart stopped working. Claire also carries the rare faulty DNA. It's caused hearing loss, and she wants the disorder to stop with her.
It makes me more determined to have a child without mitochondrial disease and without passing it down into the next generation because of seeing my mum like she was.
The idea of creating babies with DNA from three people will make some uneasy, but Parliament overwhelmingly approved it last year because of the pressing medical need. If external experts support the study in the journal Nature, then the team at Newcastle